This week on Maker Update, flipping the table on a classic game, FX Gear bike with real gears, a modern take on classic visualizers, and better CAD for skateboard ramps. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, our weekly show where we get to share our favorite maker projects from across the internet in hopes that they'll spark creativity for your next project. I'm Tyler Weingarner, and I hope you're all doing great. I can't wait to get into this week's show, so let's check out the project of the week. Last year, Works by Design blew up the internet by making this chess pawn that automatically promotes itself to a queen when it reaches the far end of the board. And yet, somehow chess players were still disappointed. That's because the humble pawn can actually be promoted to any of the other chess pieces. The queen is just the most popular choice. So what's an engineer to do? Create a pawn that can transform into any chess piece. Or rather, he's creating three more pieces, since it just isn't feasible to have one single pawn that can transform into a queen, a rook, a bishop, and a knight at the player's selection. With the queen pawn already in the books, he tackled the rook next, since that was the most similar. And after finding the right profile for the castle-y bits at the top, he moved on to the bishop, which was also a fairly similar challenge. In this case, the head splits in two to create the iconic diagonal slash. But the piece that confounded him the most, unsurprisingly, was the knight. All the other pieces were radially symmetrical, leading to similar solutions. But how do you turn a pawn into a horse? He first tried this geared mechanism to pop out the snout and the mane, and while that worked on a large scale test, he just didn't have the resolution to make it work at the scale he needed. After taking the time to solve some other problems, he realized that replacing the gears with linkages would make this all work. The final look might be a bit polarizing compared to the traditional look of the knight piece, but this isn't a traditional pawn either. Speaking of solving additional problems, the game of chess would fundamentally need to change. Ideally, each player would get two of each piece, and could arrange them in a pattern unknown to the other player to reinforce their strategy. But because each pawn looks different based on what it can be promoted to, the secrecy is blown. Instead, each pawn will be placed in front of its parenting piece. And just to make things more interesting, the promotion squares are now in the center of the board, meaning that now every pawn stands a good chance of being promoted, massively upending the game of chess. With the game changed and some massive engineering challenges accomplished, he took it on the road to the oldest chess club in the US. It's safe to say that while many were confounded by the upended rules, it was a pretty wild success. He's making the 3D printable parts and assembly instructions available on his Patreon if you want to make your own. And I also have to tip my hat at the production quality of this video. Not just the cinematography, but also the animated interstitials that help with the storytelling. It's a great watch. More projects. Have you ever heard of Atari Video Music? I hadn't before, but this is the first commercially released music visualizer. And Liz Clark is leveraging the power of the Adafruit Fruit Jam to make her own modified version of it. This is a simpler console with just two buttons and a potentiometer. The left button selects between the three visualizer modes: diamonds, party parrots, and dancing lines. Or there's an autoplay mode that cycles between all three. But the real fun happens with the potentiometer, which controls how responsive the visual elements are to the sounds detected by their microphone. A walnut veneer top really sells the retro look. And I love the look of these red LED step switches. And like any Adafruit project, you can find everything you need to build your own on the project page. From Electronoobs, we have a project on how to build your own secure off-grid walkie-talkie based on the ESP32. This is making use of the ESP Now protocol, which is a low latency Wi-Fi communication protocol that requires no router or other network infrastructure. The project is built around a custom PCB that leverages a standard ESP32 microcontroller, an I2C OLED display, a microphone, DAC, and a speaker. The walkie-talkie can be used in both broadcast mode as well as a private point-to-point mode. This is a work in progress, and at the moment, the range isn't great. It starts falling down at around 60 to 70 feet. But with better antennas and a higher voltage battery, this project could have legs. And with an increased interest in off-grid communications, this seems like a project to keep an eye on. And from well-done tips, we have a bicycle driven entirely by 3D printed gears. This might be the best definition of a fixed gear bicycle. There's a massive sprocket gear attached to the crank, connected to a series of gears all the way back to the rear wheel. To create the structure for this, he needed to weld a piece of steel flat bar, replacing one of the chainstays. The final drive sprocket fits directly onto the wheel spline, with the attachment reinforced by one of the original cassette sprockets. It's a fun project with a great result. Check it out. Now for some tips and tools from Simple Electronics, we have an I2C scanner. I2C is a great protocol for projects, but if your device doesn't offer a datasheet, it's easy to get lost. This is a device that provides both female and male DuPont connections for your I2C devices to detect their individual addresses. But it also has optional solder-on connections for stemma and quick connections. Xyla Foxlin now has her own rocket kit sold by the hobbyist rocket brand Estes. It's called Lil Spite, and it's named after her epic carbon fiber project that accelerated her personal rocketry journey. This is just the rocket body, but it supports a few different engines depending on what you're certified to fly. It's wonderful to see Xyla get this recognition, and check out the links below if you're ready to start your own rocketry journey. From I Got Distracted, we have a guide on how to get more precise control over your hobby motors. You've probably seen the jittery motion produced by brushless or stepper motors trying to hold a particular position. But this jitter can be eliminated by what's called FOC, or field-oriented control. This affords more precise positional and holding control between motor poles. This guide helps you understand how to leverage field-oriented control for finer motor precision in your own projects. And through Reddit, I learned about rampnerd.com, an online, CAD-free, parametric tool to help you build your own backyard mini skate ramp. You'll need to create an account to use the tool, and if you want the software to export building plans, you'll need to spend a little bit of money. But in the meantime, you can dream up your own ideal ramp width, height, deck, coping, and you can even add extensions of any size you like. It's a fun tool. Check it out. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we have a video by Zach the Byte-Sized Engineer for breaking down the fundamentals of all modern computing, logic gates. AND gates, OR gates, and NOT gates are the fundamental building blocks of any logical system, and they're all made of basic transistors. Zach's video does a great job of not only explaining these fundamentals, but helping you understand how they expand into truth tables and explaining how flip-flops function to store data in an active circuit. Check it out. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, that you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you don't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.